So this is the maternal pelvis, and maternal pelvis is divided into three. This is the inlet, then it has the cavity and the outlet. So first of all, the baby will go into the inlet, then it will do all the movements in the cavity, and then it has to come out by the outlet. So we learn the mechanism in that way, but before that we have to learn the quadrants of the pelvis, and then it will be easier. So what I'm doing is I'm dividing the inlet into 8 quadrants. So you take one straight line over here and one straight line over here. Then you put 2 diagonal lines. So it will be divided into 8 quadrants. And now what will I do is that whenever the baby is like this, whenever the baby is like this, the baby's head, this is transverse, this is the anteroposterior, and these two will be diagonal. So now the nomenclature will be left or right depending on the maternal pelvis. So this is the right side of the maternal pelvis, this is the left side of the maternal pelvis, and the occiput will be in respect to the fetal skull. So if we take it, this is the fetal skull, and this is the sensiput, this is the occiput. So take the occiput always. So if I keep it in this position, then the occiput is in the transverse diameter. Now which is the transverse diameter, right or left? So as it is to the left side of the maternal pelvis, so it is the left occiput transverse diameter. So this is the fetus and this is the maternal pelvis. Now we begin with this mechanism of labor, which comprises of 8 steps. So the first step will be engagement. But like I explained, this is the occiput of the fetal skull. So let's place the occiput in LOT position, which is left occiput transverse. So as you can see, occiput is facing the left side of the maternal pelvis. So this is left occiput transverse of the fetal head. But similarly, as you can see, shoulders are at 90 degrees to the fetal skull. So where are the shoulders? Shoulders are in the AP diameter. As you can see, it is in the anteroposterior diameter because they are at 90 degrees to the skull. Now we'll try to engage, which is the first step. So in engagement, what happens is the biparietal diameter will cross the pelvic inlet. That is known as engagement. So biparietal diameter is between the two parietal bones, which is 9.5 centimeters. So let us make it cross the inlet. So this is engagement, okay? When it crosses the inlet. And when it, after engagement, there will be 2 steps, that is descent and flexion. So it will go on descending and it will acquire an attitude of flexion. Like it will go on flexing upon itself. So these are the first 3 steps, and now where it has reached is at the level of the pelvic floor. So by doing these mechanisms, it has reached the pelvic floor.
Continue. Continue. Just continue.
Now at the level of the pelvic floor, it will be continuing the further process which I am showing above only. So now what it will go is undergo is internal rotation. So why am I calling it internal is because it is inside the pelvis. And now this occiput or the fetal skull will come to the AP diameter, right? It will turn, and with the turning of the fetal skull, there will be a torsion at the level of the neck, because if I turn your head to this side, your neck will be in a torsion. So this shoulders also have to rotate. Now shoulders can bear a torsion of 45 degrees, but they can't bear more than that. So this will turn 90, and with that the shoulders were in AP position. Now the shoulders will go in oblique position. It won't go to transverse, it will just go to oblique. So I initially said that there were 8 quadrants, so 8 portions of a circle. So the head went 2/8 and the shoulder from AP went just 1/8 of the circle. So this was internal rotation. And now the next step will be crowning. So this occiput, I'm removing the, so this is the occiput. This will come at the level of the symphysis pubis, okay? And when the head keeps on receding with each between the contractions. So when the head does not recede anymore in between the contractions, that is known as crowning. Now after crowning, what will happen is the delivery of the head by extension. So as you can see that this occiput is at the level of the, is in contact with the symphysis pubis, and now it will deliver like this. is the delivery of the head by extension. So now the head is outside and the shoulders are inside, but the shoulders were in an oblique diameter and the head was delivered. So now the shoulders also have to deliver. So shoulders also want to come in the AP diameter, because the AP diameter is the maximum diameter of the outlet. So what it will do is that the head will rotate. There's not just a passive rotation by 45 degrees. So if the head had delivered like this, it will come to 45 degrees like this, where there would be no movement of the shoulder. So this is known as restitution. And then there would be external rotation, where the head will again come back to its original position of transverse. That is, again it will undergo 45 degree rotation, and now the shoulders will also undergo 45 degree, that will, it will come into the AP diameter. So this is known as external rotation. Why external? Because it is taking place outside the pelvis. So after external rotation, now the shoulders will deliver. So firstly, the anterior shoulder will deliver like this. This is by lateral flexion that the shoulders will deliver, and finally this is the expulsion of the fetus.